Tässä on jarrumiehenä Väisänen ja kyytiläisenä Väisänen myös.
Sitten mennään.
Katsotaan mitä tapahtuu.
Let's go.
Yes.
Ten-hour night bus ride took us from Cusco to Arequipa. As per usual, the views did not disappoint. If you have ever played any of the Fallout games, the landscapes looked familiar. Nevertheless, this was one of the worst bus rides in Peru due to having some boiling hot heater next to us, and the air conditioning was switched off. Arequipa is the second biggest city in Peru, and we had decided to spend there 3 days. The city is known for this huge white cathedral, located in the main square. It was fun to just sit there on the bench and enjoy the sunny weather with the locals. We spent the day strolling around the central streets, but also took a short walk to Mirador de Yanahuara to check out the views of the city and the nearby volcano Misti.
Yanahuara.
Obviously, we had to take a stop at the local cafe, from where Reika found huge cinnamon buns. To sum up the highlights from the city of Arequipa for us, we really enjoyed the variety of restaurants, the overall look and feel of the central streets, but also small details like hearing this garbage truck playing Under the Sea song on a repeat.
For me, probably the best thing in the city of Arequipa was the chocolate-making course I took. I wanted to learn more about how chocolate is made and how to recognize high-quality chocolate from the fake products. Again, we enjoyed the benefits of traveling off-season, as I was the only student on the course and got the chance to ask a lot of questions. First, I learned about the history of chocolate. Did you know that, for example, the cacao beans have been used as currency? These beans have been leveraged for a long time, and so we made a drink that used to be popular before today's hot chocolate was invented. The most interesting part of the course was to learn how to temper chocolate, to use heat to alter its structure and appearance. It was pretty complex, but a convenient skill to learn. In the end, I had a small self-made pile of delicious chocolate.
Now, one of the main attractions close to Arequipa is the world's second deepest canyon, called Colca Canyon. As we had already seen quite impressive mountain ranges and Andean condors in Peru, we decided to skip the hikes in the canyon and go for a zipline adventure instead. So on the morning of the second day, we hopped on a colectivo taxi that drove 3 hours from Arequipa to the town called Chivay. From the bus station, we walked to the main square, and on the way we noticed that Chivay is a cute town to visit. It's usually a place for a stop if you're going to see the Colca Canyon. From the main square, we found yet another colectivo taxi and headed to Colca Ziplining. This company led by Nathan, that we found from TripAdvisor, had received really positive reviews, and for a reason. The guidance was engaging and the instructions were clear, so it felt safe despite the bit scary looking ziplines built across the canyon. Next up are some highlights from the ziplines we hope to remember later on.
Millä fiiliksillä?
Hauskaa.
If you want to stop spinning, you extend your legs and your arms too. Okay, ready then?
Yes.
3, 2, 1, enjoy.
Sitä vaan luottaa, että nämä paskat pysyy tässä kiinni. Eikä katkee. Ruosteinen kettinki.
Herre!
Wow.
In some lines, the braking was handled by the guides, and in some, we were in charge. In the fastest line, we used a small parachute to slow down our speed.
Tuosta tultiin vuoren päältä.
The zipline course's cost for us was 180 soles, aka 45 euros per person, as we chose the highest number of available lines.
Let's go.